Hello everyone. In this video, I want to talk about CraftLab because right now on the 3.16 PTU, we get a rework. Let's recap this. In 3.1.4, John Pritchard fixed CraftLab and it was fantastic. I will show you shortly how nice CraftLab was in 3.1.4. It used to look ahead. You could pitch up and down to support CraftLab. It was very smooth and speed was very fast. Then John Pritchard had to leave CIG. We got a new flight model in 3.5 and CraftLab was slow and boring. It didn't look ahead anymore. You couldn't pitch up and down anymore. It was not smooth and it was very slow. Now I'm curious how CraftLab is in 3.16. And to make this clear, what we are seeing now with CraftLab in 3.16 is very much intentional, I think. Still, is it good or not? I will show you now a few scenes from 3.1.4 and then I will show you 3.16. Let's get started. And here's my 3.1.4 CraftLab footage. We didn't have client-side object container streaming back then, so it's very laggy at times. But look how smooth the NUX goes over those boulders and how smooth the up and down movement is. And even this was just automatic. If you wanted to, you could pitch up and down to support CraftLab, but I was just flying straight. Actually, I wanted to see what CraftLab can do. Look, no collisions, and how smooth up and down movement is. But yeah, you could still hit things, so you couldn't be totally careless. And sometimes when you were hitting things, your NUX or Dragonfly would explode. And again, this was automatic, totally avoiding this big boulder. And now a Dragonfly and going over boulders, fine, very, very smooth, a lot of fun. And staying very close to the ground. Yeah, the fact that CraftLab used to look ahead was a big plus. And yes, you could still hit things and you could still explode. It wasn't totally foolproof, which is fine. I mean, if you're hitting a very big rock, then it's your fault. No question about this, but I wanted to test this. And look at this very smooth curve. Again, this is all automatic. I didn't pitch up or pitch down to support it. And going down very, very smooth. Wow, this was so much fun. Until 3.5 and the new flight model. Yeah, this boulder, not a problem at all. I love this very, very much. John Pritchard did such a fantastic job. Well, let's see how well CraftLab does in 3.16. Start. Yeah, we can again strafe up and strafe down, but not to a lot of altitude. This is max altitude and strafing down. This is lowest altitude. Not much of a range. But at least it's something. Okay, this thing is now really, really fast. Let's check out those boulders. This was not a problem for... Yeah, okay. I can actually stop here. This was not a problem at all for 3.1.4 CraftLab. Yeah, it's a major problem. 3.16 CraftLab still doesn't look ahead. Yeah, the nice thing about what John Pritchard did in 3.1.4 was CraftLab used to look ahead. If there was a small boulder and this boulder is really not big, then Kreflev adjusted itself and strafed up. Yeah, this is just terrible. You are hitting everything. And we also still cannot pitch up or pitch down. That's bad too. Actually, when I pitch up, I yaw to the left. When I pitch down, I yaw to the right. Yeah. Now, I don't want to make CRG look bad, but what is this all about? CRG said, yeah, we are fixing Kreflev, and Kreflev will be fine again. And then they are giving us this. Look, those boulders aren't very big. Okay, I rest my case. And now I even died. And here's my conclusion. Kreflev in 3.16. It still does not look ahead. Even a small boulder, like 50, 70 centimeters tall, can be a major obstacle. You can Kreflev into it and your vehicle can explode. Yes, I could strafe up, but what's the point of Kreflev then? We still cannot pitch up or pitch down. This was very nice back in 3.1.4. You could actively pitch up or down to support your Kreflev. And Kreflev is still not smooth, nowhere as smooth as it was in 3.1.4. In 3.16, Kreflev is fast again. Well, at least that's something. As I mentioned at the beginning of this video, it might very well be intentional that Kreflev does not look ahead anymore, that it doesn't do any adjustments on its own. But again, what is the point of Kreflev then? This was not fire and forgot in 3.1.4. You could still fly into big rocks and you could still explode. Maybe CRG wants to save server resources and we are getting a much better Kreflev in the future. And I also would like to mention that CRG has a lot of fun littering, cluttering every surface with rocks and boulders. Sometimes it's so bad that you have a hard time to find a landing spot for big ships. My rating for the 3.1.4 to 3.4 Kreflev is a 10 out of 10. John Pritchard did such a fantastic job. This was a lot of fun. For the 3.5 to 3.15 Kreflev, it's a 1 out of 10. This was just terrible. My rating for the 3.16 Kreflev is a 2 out of 10, but only because it's fast again. I can only hope that things will change when we are getting server meshing and we have a lot more server resources. Let me know what you think in the comments below. I hope you found this interesting and see you next time. Bye. Auf Wiedersehen. Are you all right? Are you all right? What's going on here? Kill it with fire. Okay. Hey, you are still here. You might want to join me on Twitter. My Twitter account is Kamoral_FFM and this is the city I live in, Frankfurt am Main. On Twitter I post about my videos and sometimes just some funny little videos. Action! Would be nice if you would join me on Twitter.